In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the community, all members. The waters of baptism are that of Christ, and those of whom we love, that we have shared with eternal glory.
For men, indeed, they punish yet in their hope full of immortality. Chastised for their own, they shall be greatly glad, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As bold and firm, he proved them in that sacrificial offering, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand the truth, and the faithful shall provide their faith in life. Because grace and mercy are with his own hands, and his care is with his left. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For to this end Christ died, and lived again, so that he might be born and both the dead and the living. The light of the past judgment on your brother or sister, or you, why do you despise your brother or sister? For we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then, each of us will be accountable to God. The word of the Lord.
Follow him to the day to share in that.
in that hope, in that possibility. And at the same time, we pray for our Lord who had gone before us. Father was a man of faith. And we pray that we trust him in God who created him, that we will now experience the fullness of the Lord's presence, the fullness of life forever. In the gospel passage that I just read, Jesus is speaking to his disciples at the Last Supper. They are about to deal with his death. They too will feel the sadness, the sting, the feeling of abandonment. But the Lord reassures them. He's going to prepare a place for them. In his Father's house, there will be many dwelling places. And he will come back to take them to himself. When Jesus made that promise to his disciples, he wasn't only speaking to the group gathered around the table at that supper. He was speaking to generations of disciples to come. On the day of his baptism, when Robert was born into the church and became a part of the body of Christ, he received that same service that the Lord would begin a place expecting to him, and that one day he would come to take him to himself, to enjoy the Father's house forever. Today we gather in prayer for that service is fulfilled, that the Lord is there to be here, to guide him to that special place in the Father's house. Now as we look for strength and comfort and pray to our brother and trust him to the Lord, at the same time it's important for us to remember and to give thanks. I'm sure as we gather here this morning, family, friends, people who talk about those who were patient in a different way, you all have memories of how this good man touched your life in some way. Perhaps even how you would change for having known him. In the very early pages of the Bible, we're told that when God created all things, he created man and woman in his own image. And so God, like all of us, is God's image. As such, he was given the ability to faith, to love, to reflect the goodness of God in his life. And I'm sure that every one of you could speak in ways that we did that. Whether as a dedicated teacher imparting knowledge and growing the horizons of the students, or perhaps a co-worker whose advice and sound judgment were appreciated. Most importantly, as a husband, as a brother, as someone who shared his love in a unique way and demonstrated true commitment. In each of these memories, we see the person who we remember. We see the love, faithfulness. We see the love who gave himself in many ways. For all of these gifts, we give thanks to God. We give thanks to God for his life and for having had the opportunity to know him. We give thanks to God for the ways that his mark will continue to make a difference in his family, in his community, in so many ways. The light of God's presence has the opportunity to shine with him. And we give thanks for the many ways that it did. Robert was a man of faith. Lord. But like so many people who grew up attending this Indo-American community in Mexico, his name had a particularly goes to our blessed mother, and entitled the Dona Fedorchina. This is very important to me, and I'm told that when Robert and Marceline moved into their house, the first image on the wall was with the Dona Fedorchina, a sign of their prayer for the protection of their home, but also the protection and care of everyone who would come there. Mary, our mother, is a caring person. She is very real in relating to us, in supporting us through the great session. And this was the work of God. I'm sure in what was life, Robert said a million words of Hail Mary many times. But I suspect that even in his illness, when so much has seized him, I would believe that the words of Hail Mary were still in his mind. When we say the prayer, Hail Holy Queen, Sovereign Regina, at the end of the prayer, we say, after this hour of exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus, O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Today, these words have particular significance as we ask our blessed mother to receive you into her arms and to present her to her son, Jesus. The anxieties, the fears, suffering in this world have been lifted from him now. And we pray that with Mary's help, with the Lord's mercy, he will enjoy the fullness of life forever. And so, as I conclude these words, I invite you to join me in praying to our blessed mother for her good father. Ask the third sexual act as we pray together, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Thank you. Lord, hear me when you look at the release. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the success of the research being conducted in the area of the Alzheimer's disease. We pray for the Lord to take the sick and dying, especially those who have been survived through the disease. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are dead and for all members of the church, that we may be prepared for the hour of our own death and that of our own family.
Thank you. to the right of the cross, and we can tell it, no way is to the river, and so we follow our life, and we know God is the Christ of the Lord. And here the hope of the blessed resurrection is God. Those saddened by the certainty of God, and the soul of the cross of the Lord, and God of the Lord. And be to the faithful Lord, and let us pray on that end. And let the certainty of God, and the rest of God, and the Lord, 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 we pray in the name of the Lord, that we recognize the sacrifice of our son, Lord, to reconcile us to the Son. That we be with our Lord, our Lord, the Son, the fullness of the Spirit, in our body and the Spirit of Christ. May he make us into a law for his needs, so that we may attain the inheritance of the Lord, especially those who are in the area of God, those who are in the Spirit of God, and those who are in the Spirit of God. And all the saints and 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 the saints. May the sacrifice of our Lord be in the prayer of our hands and peace and salvation of all the world. And please be the Lord of the Holy Spirit 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 of the Holy Spirit. In the compassion of us, the Father, and the Lord, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the Lord. Remember the Spirit of God, whom you have called in the world to yourself, and that he, who is surrounded by the Son, and that his laws be not written in the book of God, but in the air, and that his intellectuals of God, to transform our holy body into the final of his own glory. For our Lord, and his testimony, who is the truth, and his law,
Savior's command. Thank you.
trusting in God, we are here together to honor and we come to ask for love. There is sadness and heartache, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Him again and enjoy His presence. Although this congregation will serve as our own blessed God, guide us better than the joy of His kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another with faith in Christ Jesus.
Yeah.